In part three of A Rose for Emily, Miss Emily disappears for a while after her father's death. When she finally emerges from the house, the townspeople think she looks tragic and serene, particularly with her new, strange, shorter haircut. Miss Emily's girlish hairstyle isn't the only change in town. Workmen are pouring concrete sidewalks, a first for Jefferson. The foreman is Homer Barron. He's a Yankee from the North, a big, dark, ready man with a big voice and eyes lighter than his face. His unrestrained laughter attracts a lot of attention, and he quickly comes to know everyone in town. To the shock of everyone, Homer and Miss Emily start taking buggy rides together on Sundays. It's originally thought Miss Emily is just being gracious, for a Grierson would not think seriously of a northerner, a day laborer. The older generation thinks Miss Emily's actions go far beyond the duty and responsibility of being considerate of one's inferiors. Hushed rumors about Miss Emily and Homer Barron start circulating around town, all ending with poor Emily. But Miss Emily carries her head high. The narrator says this was her way of demanding the recognition of her dignity, showing that touch of earthiness to reaffirm her imperviousness. Miss Emily's earthiness with Homer reminds the narrator of an incident that happens a year after people began saying, "Poor Emily." Miss Emily, looking strained and noticeably thinner than usual, asked the town druggist for arsenic. Huh? By law, the druggist must find out the purpose of her purchase. Miss Emily refuses to say and stares at him until he looks away and goes to package it up for her. When she opens the package at home, it is labeled simply for rats. Emily's association with Homer Barron caused a scandal in Jefferson. He arrived in 1894, the year after her father's death. The official period of Reconstruction following the Civil War ended in 1877, but Northerners still flocked to the South for job opportunities. The end of the war didn't do much to change the racial attitudes of Southerners. In Jefferson, black women were required to wear aprons in public, and the black men paving the sidewalks were called derogatory names. Northerners were looked down upon too, and Homer's position as a day laborer put him quite low on the rungs of the social ladder. Someone of Miss Emily's social stature would normally do anything but associate with such a man, much less go out with him in public. The town gossips assume Miss Emily has become a fallen woman. To put it more bluntly, they think she has had sexual relations with Homer Barron. Women of this era were expected to maintain their honor and virtue by not engaging in sex before marriage. Flirtation was fine, but even the merest hint of sexual impropriety could severely damage a woman's reputation and thus her marital prospects.